And let's go to Glendale, Arizona. Here's JD Vance.
Kamala Harris is a phony who caters to whatever audience is in front of her. I don't know if you saw this, but earlier this week, look up the clip. She went down to Georgia and started talking with a fake Southern accent. I'm serious. Now, what the hell was that all about? Kamala Harris grew up in Canada. They don't talk like that in Vancouver or Quebec or wherever she came from. Doesn't matter. It's the same new liberal policies, but a different accent, whoever she's talking to. Now, on November 5th, she can go back to using her San Francisco accent because we are going to send her packing and we're going to elect Donald Trump president of the United States. Now, it's funny what Kamala Harris does, but what she has done to this country is not a laughing matter. Just today, I heard that the Biden-Harris Department of Justice cut a deal with al-Qaeda terrorist Khalid Sheikh Mohammed to avoid the death penalty. It was reported today. Now, as someone who enlisted in the Marines to serve after 9/11, that is ridiculous, but it's not surprising. Now, just think about the point that we've gotten to. Joe Biden and Kamala Harris have weaponized the Department of Justice to go after their political opponents, but they're cutting a sweetheart deal with 9/11 terrorists. We need a president who kills terrorists, not negotiates with them. Now, the weakness of this administration, of Kamala Harris's administration, has been a disaster for our country all over the world. Now, there are so many examples we could talk about, but recent news comes out of Venezuela that they cut a deal with a dictator in Venezuela, and they offered in exchange that that dictator would have free and fair elections.
JD Vance there in Arizona, one of the swing states.